My name is Didier Capel. I'm from Belgium. People hang on my every word, even the prepositions. I can disarm you with my looks or my hands. I can speak French in English. My organ donation card also lists my jar of Nutella. I'm a lover, not a fighter, but I'm also a fighter, so don't get any ideas. Find out what it is in life that you don't do well, and don't do that thing. My reputation is expanding faster than the universe. I once had an awkward moment just to see how it feels. I am the most interesting auditor in the world. I don't always drink beer, but when I do, I prefer Stella Artois. I came to the United States to become a partner at EY. I've been here for one full year and I'm still a staff. I want to know why. I see these men, Mark Bell, Steve McCreary, Howard Altschulzer, and I want to know why. What is it that these men have that I don't? I have the good looks, I have the charisma, I have the dick marking skills. So I don't understand. I walked around and asked around, what does it take to become a partner at EY? Tell me about Mark Bell.
I would describe him as being a very smooth talker. He is a very, very good dancer.
If I were to become more like this person, I would have to become a much better dancer, star in a lot of films, and join the Scientology Church.
Is known for many of his moves, such as moonwalking and a high kick.
And you might catch him doing moves like this, or like this, you know, kind of from my flash mob.
This person might be considered by, you know, some people to be kind of attractive. Had a little bit of drama. Knew quite a bit of famous people. Had a couple of hobbies that may have been not the best suited to this person's health.
He was very driven as a young man and he got to a very high position very quickly. And so having that kind of determination and dedication is a good quality.
They were a very enlightened spiritual person who did a lot of good work for other people.
Creative, successful.
This person is known by people all over. Different ages, has all sorts of interesting friends, some pretty interesting homes as well.
You want to be like him, you need to be really mean and harsh.
Tell me about Steve McCreary.
Okay, this person is very muscular and when he takes his shirt off, all the ladies go crazy. He's probably at least 1.5 times as tall as I am, so pretty tall. Very broad shoulders, long arms, long legs. Words to describe, he is in peak physical condition, works out a lot. He is very fond of gold, although he also likes silver. If you want to be like him, you need to train daily and swim numerous miles.
This person is in slightly better shape than I am. He pretty much can eat constantly and doesn't change too much. He's had a few incidents with authority at times. Pretty well known by all sorts of different people from all over the place.
A very athletic guy. I mean, he's got muscles. I mean, not as big as mine, but he's got muscles. You know, he trains all the time. You know, he wears a cap, you know, to when he's training. Now, you may see him on TV. I mean, you know, he's a very well-known guy.
He's a politician. Famous. A leader. Well-respected. He's an actor, tall, good with the ladies, international flair, been in not too many movies that many people know about. Not really sure why he's famous, but I guess it's pretty much based on his good looks. A lot of people have compared him to me.
Okay, so he's a wino, he's an expatriate, he looks really good in eyeliner, sometimes he has dreadlocks, and he is probably the most beautiful man on the earth.
Tell me about Howard Altshuler.
This is a pretty influential person in the world. Not sure I'd ever really want to hang out with him though. He's a little devious, maybe a little sketchy, but probably could throw a really good party. So there is that in his favor. But again, pretty powerful, but not necessarily somebody you'd want to get to know really well.
So a lot of people feel very differently about this man, but Oprah Winfrey really likes him a lot. He has a dog named Bo, and he lives in a big white house, and sometimes he plays basketball.
He wears glasses, very geeky looking guy, yet he's made millions of dollars by really, well, inventing one little thing, I guess. I mean, but I feel like he's monopolized now everything, but you know, this guy, but the good thing on him is, though, he does donate a lot of money to his foundation.
He is very tall and very muscular, like muscles all over the place. He has dirty blonde hair. He has a very distinct jawline. I could just say that if I was with him, I would never go down Elm Street.
My name is Didier Capel, and I am the most interesting auditor in the world.
Hey RealCo team, I bet you're watching this and you've had a couple drinks, so now this is gonna make me even funnier.
Steve McCreary, Howard Altshuler, and I wanna... Sorry.
It was beautiful!
I'll do it again.
He's known for a black tank or turtleneck. Wait, start that one over. Can you start over?
So now for the last guy that I'm gonna describe, and I don't know why I got all three guys to describe, but...
Hi.
Hi.
Can I?
Yes.
Sorry.
I see Mark Bell, Steve McCreary, Howard Altshuler, and I see...
Okay, so now the last guy that I'm going to describe to you, and by the way, I don't know why I got all guys on this. I would really like to have described maybe a blonde, you know, big boobs or something. Sorry.
And I personally like him, although he's a little old for me.
My name is Didier Capel, and I'm from Belgium.